Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you all for being here this afternoon. I am delighted to welcome executives here from the U.S. Housing Department of Housing and Urban Development that are here today in Atlanta, as well as the executives and representatives from Aid Atlanta and Positive Impact Health Centers. Most of you know that housing opportunities for persons with AIDS and HIV, or HOPWA, this is a federal program that is dedicated to addressing the housing needs of low-income residents living with HIV/AIDS and their families. Here in Atlanta, we work with partners like Aid Atlanta, and these partners are able to provide stable housing to our and the Positive Impact Health Centers and their residents who are experiencing homelessness or at risk of becoming homeless. I'm happy to report that during the last program year, the City of Atlanta impacted more than 5,000 HOPWA participants through services provided by our housing opportunity program with people with AIDS, this project and the sponsors. Currently, the City of Atlanta has also prioritized acquiring more property as a way to increase our affordable HOPWA housing stock and to maintain long-term affordability. During this will allow us to better leverage our funds to meet the needs of our program participants. Most of these participants won't be able to get far without these kind of provisions, so this is critical. But all of this work requires resources. We depend on the federal government and our partners at HUD, who you see here, to help us meet the needs of these projects and these sponsors like Aid Atlanta, as well as Positive Impact. And that brings us to where we are here today. When I took over as mayor, I got to meet these great people here from HUD, some out in the audience and some right here. And they told me, hey, mayor, you got a problem. People are getting paid too slow, contracts are taking too long, and I was like, I just got here, how I got a problem? And they were like, you gotta do something about it. And so Commissioner Deborah London, who is over, she's the commissioner of our grants and community development department, she and her team, we got right on it and really have taken us from paying people in 174 days, and now we're within our contract compliance of 30 days. And this is the type of work that really makes community members want to work with the City of Atlanta again, because folks were saying this is not how we are able to, be able to take care of our residents when we got a $1 million or $1.5 million or even a $500,000 backlog of reimbursements that haven't been met. So her team, the grants management team, some of them are in the audience today, hats off to y'all for getting that work done, because there are lives on the line, and you saw that, and you really stepped up big to deliver for the people of Atlanta and this region. So hats off to you, and I'm thankful for all the partners in that, our COO and the people at HUD for being patient with us. We didn't want to give back any money, and we didn't want anybody to lose their vouchers or their opportunities. So together, we're working together, and I'm happy about that. And so now I can happily see the HUD folks when they come here. We got things right, and I love seeing my HUD people because I know we're on the right path. So now I'd like to turn it over to HUD's Deputy Assistant Secretary, Jameen Bryan, to talk more about why we're here today. Jameen.
Thank you. Well, hello, everyone. Mr. Mayor, everyone, thank you for having gathering today and giving me the opportunity to come into your city and really make a terrific announcement, not only for the City of Atlanta, but for 11 communities across the United States. So late last year, HUD issued a notice of funding opportunity, which made funds available for organizations to apply for programs that will help meet the needs of people who are living with HIV/AIDS. We called the NOFO the Housing Interventions to End the HIV Epidemic. So I am proud to announce today that we are awarding $26 million in HINT grants to 11 communities across the nation. But I am especially pleased to do the best part of my job, which is to come into a city and make the announcement directly to the recipients. So today, in the City of Atlanta, Positive Impact and AIDS Atlanta are both receiving $2.5 million each But for the first time, these two organizations will now also be direct recipients of competitive HOPWA funding. This is a commendable step by these organizations that will benefit many in this community. Through HINT, grantees receive funding to provide housing assistance, support, and supportive services for eligible individuals and families, and for coordination and planning activities, and for grants management and administration. Through all HOPWA funding, especially HINT grants, HUD seeks to end the HIV epidemic by elevating housing as an effective structural intervention. While most HOPWA funding is awarded through annual formula allocation of funds, HINT is a competitive award. It is focused on driving best practices in the field. You and other awarded communities took time to craft thoughtful responses to HUD's NOFO, and the innovative thinking of you and your peers is represented well through these awards. HUD awarded projects with exemplary and innovative qualities, including incorporation of housing first principles, community level coordination, data collection with emphasis on stable housing and positive health outcomes. The use of cultural humility in providing housing and services is also a component. In addition to creating a systematic approach to advance equity in underserved communities that can serve as a national model. I am particularly excited about Aid Atlantic and Positive Impact Health Centers proposing projects that not only complement the work already underway in Atlanta, but focusing on significant challenges faced by most underserved people with HIV.